click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to the subject Digital Image Processing. This video is from chapter number 4, where we are going to have the methods for enhancement of quality of image, hence the name image enhancement, and that too we are particularly seeing for the spatial domain, hence the name image enhancement in spatial domain. Now it's time to have another image transformation technique for image enhancement, and that technique is log transformation. So let us begin with the topic and see the details. So here we can begin with our topic, log transformation, one of the popular and very simple image enhancement technique in spatial domain. The subject is digital image processing. So for log transformation, we can have first of all the representation of all the basic gray level transformation functions that we have shown into the earlier case also. These are used for image enhancement purpose. So this is the diagram that is showing us the three types: linear, logarithmic, and the power transformation. So here the image negatives, image identity function, we can represent by these two diagonals of the square, along with we can have the logarithmic transformation, which is our topic, along with we shall be addressing the inverse logarithm, and the next topic it will be the nth root, that is the power transformation. So the input gray levels and output gray levels here we have represented by R and S. So in such background, here taking the help of S and that of the R, the general form of the logarithmic transformation we can represent by the equation. The equation is giving S is equal to C logarithm for 1 plus R here. So see, basically R is the input intensity level, whereas S is the output intensity level. The role is also played by the constant C here. The logarithmic function of course is taken as the name is there. And here we can see that the C is a constant, and it is assumed that the R is having the value greater than or equal to 0. The shape of the logarithmic curve that we have shown here. So here we can state that this transformation actually maps a narrow range of low intensity values in the input to a wider range of output levels. So here we can see that there is a great rise. So as we can have the representation of gray levels right from 0 to L minus 1. So this is a narrow range, 0 to L by 4. So in this much of span, we are taking the span right from 0 to here we can go for 3 L by 4. So a narrow range of low intensity values onto the input side will map to the wider range of output levels here represented by this particular curve. And opposite is also true for the higher values of the input levels. So for input levels, if you are taking a span right from L by 4 to that of the L minus 1, we are having a span onto the output, that is 3L by 4 to L minus 1. Hence, the reversal of both the statements are true for the curvature shown by logarithmic transformation. Now the transformation of logarithmic type is actually used to expand the values of the dark pixels into the image, while compressing the higher level values here. So that is one of the basic application and the criteria with which we can select the method for certain cases, we can say. The opposite is true for the inverse log transformation is also. So there will be the expansion of the values of the brighter pixels while compressing the lower level intensity values, we can say, in the case of inverse log transformation. So any curve having a general shape that, as like we have shown into the previous figure, would accomplish this particular spreading or compressing of the intensity levels, the gray levels we can say. But the power law transformations, which is supposed to be addressed by the next topic, are much more versatile for this particular purpose. But still the logarithmic transformation, inverse logarithmic transformation are used. The log transformation function has important characteristic that it compresses the dynamic range of images with large variations into the pixel value. A classic illustration we can make with a certain application example in which the pixel values have a large dynamic range, and that is actually the Fourier spectrum. At the moment, we are concerned only with the image characteristics of the spectra, and it is not unusual to encounter the spectrum values that range from 0 to 10 to the power 6 or higher. While processing numbers such as represented by the digital images, so there is seems to have no problems while working with the computer, but the image display systems generally will be not having able to have reproduction faithfully such as the wide range of intensity values. The net effect for this particular logarithmic transformation is that the significant degree of intensity detail can be lost in the display of a typical Fourier spectrum. So this actually can be the limitation or drawback while working with the logarithmic transformation, as it will be loss of the quality, we can say. So now the example here we take, this is actually the first image, the name is Fourier spectrum. In this particular image, the entire portion you find black, and this is actually the white spot that we are concerned with. The information is confined to this region only. If we apply the logarithmic transformation to such a Fourier spectrum, the output we can obtain that is shown by this particular image. So see here, the details of whiteness seems to have enhanced here. So the name here, it is the result of applying the log transformation to input image. Now we shall discuss the details, how exactly this is significant to have log transformation on such type of Fourier spectrum. The illustration that we have seen into the previous figure is having a Fourier spectrum, and the values of this Fourier spectrum range from 0 to 1.5 times 10 raised to the power 6 here. When these values are scaled linearly for the display in an 8-bit system environment, the brightest pixel will dominate the display at the expense of the lower values of the spectrum. So this is the important thing with case of logarithmic transformation, we can say. This effect of dominance is illustrated by vividly seeing the relatively smaller area of the image in previous figure A that is not perceived actually as the complete black, we can say. If instead of displaying the values in this manner, we first apply the equation that we have won for the logarithmic transformation, the equation is S is equal to constant C times logarithm of 1 plus R. So here we are going to take the case of C is equal to 1, hence S will be equal to logarithm of 1 plus R. So this will be for the spectrum values, and then the range of the values shall become 0 to 6.2, which is more manageable. Now the figure B that we have seen as the result of logarithmic transformation, it has showed the scaling effect along with the new range of linearly displaying the spectrum in the same 8-bit environment. The wealth of the detail visible in this image as compared to the unmodified display of the spectrum is evident from these pictures. So this is the significance of working with the logarithmic transformation. The information quality has been enhanced by applying the logarithmic transformation for such image. So this was again the view of figure A and figure B. So I hope you have understood the topic logarithmic transformation. By the next lecture, we are going to have a simple demonstration while working with MATLAB programming. Whatever a simple relationship between S and R we have shown, that we are trying to have model in the MATLAB programming, and we shall see the results of logarithmic transformation with certain input images. So as you like these topics and want some more details of the subject, so that time you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.